here. Welcome and thank you for joining us on this beautiful evening. What a night for rock and roll, yes. Let's make some big noise for Loverboy kicking some ass out here, yeah. I really do want to say thank you to Loverboy. This band has toured with Loverboy for many years, and they are a joy to be around. They have great songs, great personalities. Woo! Mike Reno's a fucking great singer. Woo! And I want to thank them and their crew for being with us. Now, all we want to do tonight is to have a fucking great time with all of you. I'm not sure you heard the question I said. Are you ready? Let's get this rock and rolling. Thank you. It's nice to have someone to wait for. It's nice to have someone waiting for you, because that means you have someone in your life, and that is a tremendously good thing. Yes. Instead of a phone in the second row in the middle of a concert. Just saying. That's the soft, romantic part of that equation. But what about the lusty part? What about the dirty, gritty, lusty part, huh? I just want to address the ladies in the audience tonight. Hello, ladies! Hello, ladies! Ladies, hello! Just a quick question. How many of you ladies in here tonight have what you would call a naughty partner in your life? How many of you would like to have a naughty partner in your life? New Jersey, we have a lot of work to do. You gotta dirty your shit up a little bit. For those of you who have or would like to have that naughty partner in your life, we're going to dedicate this next song to you. How about a little dirty white voice?
Baby, if you feel that now, I know what you're looking for.
thank you, ladies. We are nothing without you. That is the God's truth, as it is. A little bit of business here. I want you to take a look at these screens. There's going to be a QR code. You can put your phone up there, go to the website, sign up, and you'll get all kinds of backstage and on-the-road stuff that's exclusive to you. And you'll be notified of things before anybody else. You'll be ahead of everyone else. You'll be better than everybody else. That's my commercial for tonight. As you can see, we've got many talented technicians transferring the stage into what I call the acoustic portion of the show. That's right, we don't always get to do this kind of thing, you know. Different setup, different instruments. But on this tour we said, fuck it, yes we are! So we're gonna do a few songs for you in this different format. If you don't mind me taking a second to just adjust myself musically. So this first one is from the 2009 Can't Slow Down album. And we did a single for this, we did a video. I'm very proud to be a co-writer on this album. It's called When It Comes to Love. it's like it's almost like it's as humid as New Jersey in here. I got a little bit of Jack Daniels. Cheers to you. Such an amazingly underestimated, well-crafted song. It's got a floating kind of ethereal feel, and it's a lot of great imagery, and it's really great to sing. So we'll do it for you. It's called Girl on the Moon.
Searching for a face I can never find.
that. I feel funny having to say this, but in this day and age with AI, you know, artificial intelligence, and bands going out on the road and having all of their tracks on computers and not really singing or playing live, I think it's important for you to know that everything you're hearing tonight is being played and sung live. That means it might not be perfect, but it will be real, and that's what you deserve. And I think that's a perfect way for me to segue into introducing you to my beautiful bandmates up here on stage. Starting with this guy, second to your right over there, I want you to take a deep look into his dark, soulful eyes. Look closely. Do a close-up on his face. If you look at those soulful eyes, you'll see a thousand years of rhythm, rhyme, vibe, and feel, and touch, and groove. Greasiness, harmony, love for the sound that sounds so good. And just a little bit of sexual tension. Keep things going. He is so good at what he does. He lives it, he breathes it, it is in him. I simply call him the magician. Please, Luis! Sitting on a box, which is called a cajon. Look at his face. If you look up amazing fucking rock and roll drummer in the dictionary, you're gonna see his picture. Picture will be at least 10 years old. He's got the appropriate and positively rock and roll drummer tattoos. Yes. He's got a goatee that he knows how to use. But besides all that, he knows what the fuck he's doing behind them skins. That's right. He knows how to keep it on the sock. That's right. Does it really good. I'm telling you people, like few others. So make some big noise on the drums and percussion for Chris, the Pleasure Razor Ranger. And next to me here in the omnipresent blue shades and impish grin, is a beautifully talented, wonderful human being. Not just that, I think you're an old soul. It drinks fresh beer. I've been around this man for a long time and I've seen him constantly working, playing, practicing, improving. Even after all these years with all his knowledge, he's trying to find a way to make perfect better. And somehow he does it. Got strings in his blood. Yes, he does. And he's an incredibly lively, active, and wonderful social human being. So if you see him out on the street, please offer him a very delightful and complicated IPA, all right? And to his left, for you, that man behind the keys, look at him, he's tall, he's lean, he is one sexy, badass keyboard-killing machine. Yes, he is! See him out here doing it right! He'll fuck you up in any kind of style plan you throw out to him. He knows everything on that keyboard from the low notes to the high notes. I'm gonna say this as long as I can. He's about to become a first-time daddy. Here next to me, in a place a long time ago and far, far away, I'm sure you recognize him from a band that he was a very potent part of. I'm talking about Duncan. Yeah. From the 80s. But also, this man can only be described as a true rock and roll warrior. He is normally bounding around the stage like the mysterious jackalope we've heard about. But he's been temporarily and only slightly sidelined, and he will be back bounding around again with us soon. So, I just want you to understand the courage and willpower of this man who is willing to play through the pain. And that's the truth. I'm thinking of maybe even after you recover to cause you pain to make you play with better, even better feeling.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
No, really, seriously, I am truly inspired by this man being willing to sit up here and play. And when we talked about doing this leg and he had this issue, he said, "There's no fucking way I'm not gonna rock New Jersey." If you would please, I would like you to raise a raucous sound for the man who is almost 100% human, Titanium Jeff Pilsen.
Yeah! Thank you. Thank you very much.
You know, we could not have picked a better place to end this tour than right here in Jersey. Because of you. Talk up this guy who, when he joined the band, we headed straight to the top. It took us 18 years to get there, but we're here. And, listen, there's a lot to say about this guy. He's an incredible cook. He was a Chopped champion. But on a serious note, I happen to think he's one of the greatest rock voices out there. I really do. And I have no doubt in my mind that he is the best performing rock frontman that's out there right now, and if you agree with me, give it up for Kelly Hansen!
Thank you. You're more than coming, more than I deserve, for sure. Thank you, guys. All right, but enough of that crap, okay? We got another song for you. Now, I know you know this song, so I want to hear you sing along and clap in your hands, and let's make some big noise together on this. Maestro? Thank you. Oklahoma to the world in March of 1977. Years, that's a long time. If my old ass blurry eyes don't see me as I cast a loving glance upon your communal countenance, I'm going to say that some of you are also over 40.
Thank you.